John's a big Tigers supporter. He just got solar power installed. He used to spend $600 per quarter on power, but with his new bill plus Metro Solar Easy Payments, he's saving $169 per quarter from day one. That adds up to $88,000 after 25 years. So no, John can't own his power company, but he can own his solar system.
G'day Tiger fans, welcome to Raw Vision and the spotlight on Round 12 v North Melbourne Sunday afternoon at Etihad Stadium. It's brought to you by Metro Solar. As always, I'm joined by Danny Daly. How are you, Danny?
I'm going very well, mate, and I must start off by saying congratulations on the Hall of Fame award last night.
Yeah, it was a good night. It was very much a surprise. I'm very humbled about it. And yeah, we had a few frothies, so I'm not the best today. So just bear that in mind when we're doing this, Danny.
Well, you've actually done well to turn up. Yeah, I thought I was going to be one out today, asking the questions and answering them.
But, I was going to bring a beer in for you, but I thought it was unprofessional.
I would have had it.
Anyway, we better get on to it. It's a massive game this week against North Melbourne.
It is a massive game. They're all massive at the minute for us, aren't they? So they're obviously in good form, North Melbourne, and a bit up and down. So it just gives us another opportunity, I suppose, to hopefully try and get a win on the board.
Well, let's have a look at the team. Not finalised as yet, obviously, not till Sunday. So squads at this stage. Any definite outs?
Yeah, unfortunately, Sean Griggs out with a bit of a hamstring. It was probably touch and go, but there's a little bit of a strain there, so he'll miss 1 week. So he's the only one at the minute at this stage.
Yeah. Well, let's look at someone who's definitely coming in, Anthony Miles. He's had to wait a few weeks since he was elevated onto the list, but his numbers in the VFL have been outstanding.
Yeah, it's been a terrific story for him. Obviously, we've been trying to ascertain when the best time to play him is, and he's probably been in good form for about 6 or 7 weeks, and he's probably had an opportunity to play, but we just haven't gone down that road. But now's a good opportunity for us to play with Grigger out, and also the way North Melbourne play with their contested style of football, it gives him a great opportunity to come in and play a role for us.
He's a contested ball player, isn't he? That's his strength.
Absolutely, and I think Tiger fans out there might have seen him in the pre-season against Collingwood and Essendon, had a couple of good games there at stoppages and helping Cotchie out, so he's earned his spot, and I'm sure he'll come out and play the role that we asked him to play.
And we spoke to Nick Flostone on Raw Vision the other day. He's definitely back in as well.
Yeah, he's playing. He'll come back in and fit straight back into our back line, no doubt. He's missed a couple of games and it's hurt us, so he's a welcome addition back into the side.
I was reading the paper this morning, just looking at my own article in there, Danny, but I did notice Trent Cotchin spoke about smashing in this week, contested ball and tackling. That's going to be a real focus.
It is, and I think Damien said in his dissection yesterday that we were embarrassed and it was a mediocre performance, and not the type of performance that our players want to wear their jumper in. You know, it's when we play footy, we want to go out there and have a crack and show some effort and put some pressure on the opposition, and we were poor in that as a playing group and a coaching group in making sure that happens. So it's probably been the number one focus for this week.
Nick Del Santo is in terrific form. He's running his own race a little bit across half back, and he really sets them up. Do you play a negative type role on him?
Yeah, I think we might have to. I think you've seen when they win games of footy, he's one of the ones along with Boomer Harvey there who have a big influence on the game. So he's played behind the footy, which he did last week. He's played on the wing or up forward as half forward. So, you know, between him and Harvey as their outside players, we've really got to hopefully get a couple of guys who can just nullify their influence.
With Boomer, is it just a fact of letting him get his ball up the ground? Because you don't want him inside 50. We know he's a goal kicker.
Yeah, he's a superstar, Boomer. Yeah. I was fortunate enough to coach him I was at North for 7 years and I coached him for 2 years. And yeah. I used to say to him, sides will try and make you get the possessions in the back half, make sure you get him 1-2s running in the forward half. So I know how he likes to play. So exactly what you said. We've just got to make sure he can't get the 1-2s and break the lines in the forward half. And if he gets possessions down back, well and good. But he's having an outstanding season. So the more we can nullify these two, I think it'll give us every opportunity.
Their back line is outstanding. Scott Thompson, an All-Australian fullback, but Lockie Hansen's the one that really sets them up with his intercept play.
Yeah, he does. And the other one who they might get back this week is Nathan Grimer as well. Yeah. They've got Spud Ferrito down there as well. So they've got a back line who like to zone back, like the vision you see here. So our ball movement's going to be really important. We can't just bomb it into them like this.
Yeah.
We've got to be smart about using the footy through the midfield and, you know, using our hands or short possession game with our feet. Like, these sort of edits are just playing straight into their hands.
So what do you do with Hansen? You need to engage him. You need someone to take him out of the dangerous area.
Yeah, we do. I think the last couple of weeks, you see sides, including ourselves, who play their forwards up in paddock, which allows these guys to zone off. So I think it's really important that, as you said, our forwards engage them. Don't give them the opportunity to zone off, or if they want to zone off, we can use those guys through hit-ups or, get it into the fat side for them. But again, last year against them, our first 10 inside 50s, we kicked directly back to Hanson. He had 13 marks against us last year. We just butchered the football inside 50. So you might see us playing a little bit of a keepings off type game until we can get into position to hopefully do hit-ups or get into a position where we can take a mark and they don't have intercept marks, because that's how they get their game up and going.
Certainly is another highlight this week. It's actually Damien Hardwick's 100th game as coach and Brad Scott's 100th game as coach. So it'll be a bit of a battle in the coach's box.
Yeah, it will. You told me that stat before.
Yeah, didn't you know that?
No, you come up with some beauties every week.
That's what we do here.
Well, you're obviously doing a great job, because I don't think anyone at the club would know that apart from you.
Well, is he going to run through a banner dimmer or not?
I think he might run through the North Melbourne huddle at the start of the game, I reckon, because he's been obviously disappointed with the way we've been going, and obviously there's been quite a bit of heat on Dimmer, but he's a terrific coach and he's got a lot of pride, so he might actually go and whack Scott as well. I don't know what he'll do, but
it'd be a good battle. I'd pay to see that. Anyway, we wish Dimmer all the best and the team. Thanks, Danny.
No worries. It's always a pleasure coming on, and you're going back to have a few more frothies this afternoon to keep celebrating.
I'm going to lay on the couch now and just get a little bit of rest. But don't forget, Sunday arvo, you can press red for Kev. Kevin Bartlett's calling the game. So get online with that. If you can't get to the game, we'll see you there at the footy.